So in this chapter, we discuss about the light here. With the help of the light, we can see anything during the daytime. Okay. And with the absence of the light, we cannot be observe anything. Okay. So during the daytime, we can be observe the river, mountain, trees, plants, animals, birds, all these things we can be observe. Okay. And at night time, we can be observe, we can be see moon as well as stars. Okay. So you are able to see the words as well as sentence printed on this paper, or you can be seen all these things in your screen mobile with the help of the light. Now, next, what makes things visible? So here, as we know that I see the object, okay. With the help of our eyes, we can be observe so many things, but we cannot be we can see an object in the dark. No. So it means that eyes alone cannot be seen any object. So it is when light form an object enters our eyes that we see the object. Okay. So the light may be have seen emitted by the object, or it may be have been reflected by it. So with the help of the reflector rays of the light, we can be visible with our eyes. Okay. So here, during the daytime, we can be observe so many things. Okay, we can be see the buildings, trees, plant, okay, birds, animal, because the rays are reflected from such type of the object and we can be identified. Okay. Now, next one is the laws of the reflection. That is 16.1 activity. Here, that is for this activity, we can be understood that phenomena of the reflection of the light, that is a material, that is which type of material we can be, plain mirror, plain mirror, comb, torch, white sheet of paper, such type of the things, material should be required for such type of the activity. And with the help of activity, we can be understand the phenomena of the reflection of the light. So here, for as shown in figure, we have to fix the white sheet of paper, okay, on the table, and take the comb and close all its opening using strip of the black paper. Here we have to hold the comb perpendicular to the sheet of the paper and throw light from the torch through the opening of the comb. So with the help of that is right, that is comb, and beside that there is a torch. Okay, so here what we should take, here we take the first plain mirror in a stand. Okay, we take the first table, and table you have to spread the one white paper, and in the corner, that is one side, you have to be attached the plain mirror. Okay, and beside there, that is you take the one plastic comb. Okay, and from one side you take the torch. Okay, now you have to switch on the torch, so light ray from the torch, that is the incident ray, falls on the comb, and from the comb it will be transfer to the plane mirror. Okay, so here we have to be adjust to the plane mirror, that is a reflected ray we can be observed. Okay, white rays, it is a reflected, it is an incident ray and reflected ray, it is we can be observed. So here reflected ray from the mirror can be seen on the paper. Okay, so that is white ray path, it is a, this is the from the comb or from the torch, it is an incident ray, and from the reflect, okay, from the plane mirror, it is a reflected ray. It is yes. Any question? Wait. Now you can show the screen. No. Now you can show the screen. Yes, okay. So we will continue. We will continue this chapter. Okay, wait. चालू छे बीजा पर मुकली दो ने होले विल स्टार्ट दैट इज कंटिन्यू दैट इज एक्टिविटी दैट इज एक्टिविटी फर्स्ट दैट इज टू अंडरस्टैंड द फिनोमिना ऑफ द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ द लाइट सो फॉर दैट वी रिक्वायर द प्लेन मिरर कॉम्ब टॉर्च व्हाइट शीट ऑफ द पेपर ओके सो हियर In this, that is a reflection light, that is first we require the white paper as shown in the figure. You should be kept on the table. And from the one side, you attach the plane mirror, okay? And between that is a torch and the mirror, okay? You should be kept the one plastic comb, okay? As shown in the figure. And with the help of the torch, that is from one side, you have to be switch on of the light. So we can be observed the ray of the light that is these rays are known as the incident ray and as we know that from the plane mirror it will be reflected back the rays will be reflected back as you shown in the figure okay so what you have to observe from this activity that is reflected ray from the mirror can be seen on the paper and what is at the conclusion so a ray of light is reflected from the mirror ray of light is reflected from the plane mirror so these are the we have to understand the phenomena of the reflection of the light now after striking the mirror the ray of light is reflected in another direction as you know that and the light ray which strike any surface is called the incident ray okay here that is a As you know that this from moves from the comb side is the incident ray and from the plane that is from the plane side goes in other direction it is a reflected ray okay so the ray that comes back from the surface after reflection it is known as the reflected ray Now, the next one that is we have with the help of the scale and pencil, okay, that is from the one side of the mirror, okay. So that is from the incident ray, okay. That is from the right side. It is a incident ray, and where incident ray attach, okay, and the plane mirror that is center point, okay. It is a normal. You draw the normal, okay. And from outside is a reflected ray. So incident ray and reflected. That is so this point. That is from the normal we can be draw. So draw the line showing the position of the plane mirror. The incident ray and the reflected ray on the paper with the help of your friends and remove the mirror and the comb afterwards. Okay. So draw a line making an angle 90 degree. To the line representing the mirror at the point where the incident ray strike the mirror and this line is known as the normal so here what you have to be do you have to from that plane mirror okay with the help of the from one side torch light it is a incident ray okay so these are incident ray and from the plane surface it will be reflected back and from incident ray and reflected ray both rays are meet at the one point and this one point you have to be mark the point on the screen of the plane mirror okay now remove the plane mirror and with the help of the scale okay and you have to be draw the one perpendicular line where they are meet to each other okay so these are known as the normal okay these are known as the normal so incident ray reflected ray and the normal okay we can be observed in this figure now here that is a angle we discuss about the different type of the angle incident angle reflected angle okay so here the angle between the normal okay the center figure that is a This is the plane surface, that is the plane surface, that is incident ray, reflected ray and the normal. Okay, so the angle between the normal and incident ray, the angle between the normal and incident ray, these are known as angle of incident, that is angle I. Okay, and the angle between the normal and the reflected ray, the angle between the normal and the reflected ray, so this angle are known as the reflected angles, that is small r. The angle between the normal and the reflected ray, these angles are known as reflection angle or angle of reflection, that is small angle, small r. Okay, now we have to measure the incident angle and the reflection angle, that is angle I and angle r, both you have to be measured. Okay, angle I and angle r, you have to both the measured. Okay, now repeat the activity at several time of by changing the angle of the incident. Okay, you have to change the angle of incident. It means that you have to change the incident ray with the help of the torch. Okay, angle will be changed. So reflection angle, it will be also be changed. Okay, so here and all this you have to measure, that is angle of incident and angle of reflection. So when you change the angle of incident and at that time change the reflection angle also change here. It means that first time suppose you have to measure the angle, okay, that is 30 degree. Okay, you have to measure the angle 30 degree, and at the same time that is angle of reflection and normal you have to measure. So at the time angle of reflection, it means that the angle between the normal and reflection rays, okay, you have to be measured. So it means that suppose angle of incidence 30 degree, then angle of reflection also 30 degree. Now you have to change the direction, that is the change the angle of torch. Okay, so suppose it is 40 degree, then to measure the angle of reflection is also 40 degree. Okay, now next, that is 50 degree of the angle of incident, then angle of reflection also 50 degree. Then you have to change the angle of incident 60 degree and measure the angle reflection 60 degree. Then after 70 degree, then angle of reflection is also 70 degree. Okay, so from this, all this we have to conclude that here the relation between the angle of incident and the angle of reflection, both are the same. It means that angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay, so angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection, and this is the law, this is the one law of the reflection, laws of the reflection. So which are, from this activity we can conclude, that is laws of the reflection. So that is angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection, and this statement, it is known as the laws of reflection. Okay, again I repeat this, the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. Okay, angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection, and this is known as the laws of the reflection. Now next one, that is activity 16.2. We have to discuss, that is a 16.2 activity. We have to perform activity 16.1 again. That is so previously, that is we have to take the one plain paper, okay, on a cardboard paper you should be take and kept it on the table. Kon mic off, kon off che, on che baka koi bula bhumo padya kare chandar. Who is this? Microphone on karine bola rakhe chhe. Kon se student se bhi. Okay, we'll continue the activity, that is activity 16.2. Okay, so this activity to show that the incident ray, reflected ray and the normal at the point of incidence lies in the same plane, we have to be proved. So here, that is, we have to fix the white sheet paper on a table, okay, and cut the projecting portion of the sheet in the middle as shown in the figure. Now you take the one comb, okay, and close all its opening except one in the middle, and hold the comb perpendicular to the plane of the sheet as shown in the figure. Now throw the light from the torch through the opening of the comb from the one side, okay, and place the strip of plain paper in the path of light ray, and look the reflected ray which extend to the projected portion of the paper. Okay, now bend that part of the projected portion on the which reflected rays falls. So you have to be observed that reflected ray cannot be seen on the bent part of the paper. Okay, so and bring the paper back to the original position and observe the reflected rays again. So from this activity, we can conclude that the incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal drawn at the point of incidence lies in the same plane. Okay. So here, from this activity, that is, we show that the incident ray, reflected ray, and the normal at the point of incidence lies in the same plane. Okay. Now here, when whole sheet of paper is spread on the table, so it represents one plane. It represents the one plane. Here, the incident ray, normal at the point of incidence, and reflected ray all are in this plane. It is in same plane. Okay. Here, incident ray, normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all are in the same plane. And this is known as the another law of the reflection. What is the first law? That is, as we previously discussed, that is activity number one. That is, angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. This is the first law of reflection. Angle of incidence is equal to the angle of reflection. Okay. And second one, what is the second law of incidence? That is, second law of reflection. That is, the incident ray, the normal at the point of incidence, and the reflected ray all are lie in the same plane. Okay, so this is the another law of the reflection. This is the another law of the reflection. Now here, now with the help of this torch, in place of the torch, okay, there is a here Pahli and Bujo, okay, Bujo perform this activity outside the classroom with the help of the sun. Okay, instead of the torch. Instead of the torch, they do the activity with the help of the sun. Okay. Now here, Buju remembered in class 7. Okay. He has studied the some features of the image of the object in a plane mirror. So here in 7th standard, as we discuss about the plane mirror, that is the angle of reflection, incident ray, normal, all these are we have to be discussing in 7th standard. So just we have to remind. Was the image erect or upside down? Okay. Was it of the same size as the object in a plane mirror? Did the image appear at the same distance behind the mirror as the object was in front of it? Could it be obtained on the screen? Okay. So all this the we have to understand a little more about the formation of image by plane mirror. By the one activity, that is 16.3 activity. So here, that is as you know that in the morning session we have to be very ready for our school. So at that time we have to be stand near our plane mirror. Okay, in a plane mirror we observe the image. Our image we can be observed. So now which type of the object you have to be observed in plane mirror? Okay, so. First question, was the image erect or upside down? Just we have to remind 7th standard, that is activity. Another, was it is the same size as the object? Did the image appear at the same distance behind the mirror as the object was in front of it? Could be obtained on the screen? So all these we have to be discussed in 7th standard. Okay, later on we have to more detail in 16.3 activity.